Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, whatever time it is that you're joining me for this video. Thanks once again for clicking on the PenBoyRoy Fountain Pen Review channel. The subject of today's video is the Twsbi Eco Fountain Pen. Before I get started, don't forget to check out my new PenBoyRoy t-shirts in the link below. They are sold exclusively through inkjournal.com and are limited in supply. Also, don't forget to check out the Pentertainment Podcast, episode number 32, where the odd oink, Tom and I, talk about pens as well as an interesting tale about my watch buying experience at Tourneau. A disaster of a story with a happy ending due to people with similar passions as the fountain pen virus infected. Also, depending on when you're watching this, episode number 33, where the odd oink and I get figgy with it, with special guest, Fig Boot on Pens. Very exciting stuff. Just be forewarned, it's not for children. You have been warned. Twsbi, a brand that is based in Taiwan, has been around for over the last 40 years, acting as a manufacturer of OEM parts for other brands, until the year 2009 when they realized how awesome they are and decided to start making their own products. They started off with a mechanical pencil that they called the Precision. Following the pencil, they released several models of fountain pens, including the Classic, the Diamond 580, the VAC 700, mini versions of the Diamond 580 and VAC 700, as well as updated, improved versions of them. Later, in the summer of 2015, the brand made a bold move with the release of one of the most inexpensive piston-filling fountain pens on the market with our pen today, the Twsbi Eco. The Eco was named from an abbreviation of the word economical due to how inexpensive the pen is considering its pedigree. That's all I have for the background information. Moving on to the neutral zone, those elements about the pen that are neither good or bad, or can be good or bad depending on you. The nib is a number 5 size stainless steel Yovo nib. There is some scroll work on the shoulders, and under the breather hole is the brand logo. Under the brand logo is the brand name. Under that, although you can't see it because of the section rim, is an EF to indicate that this is an extra fine. The feed is a single ink channel feed with fins that are very delicate. The nib and feed are friction fit into the transparent section. At the tip of the section are 3 triangular nubs to assist the newer user in gripping the pen. However, considering how close they are to the tip, I'm not sure that most writers will even encounter them. The section has a moderate taper from the threads to the tip. The section threads are on the outside of the section and are used in capping. After the threads is an O-ring that, when fully capped, blocks the last receiving thread of the cap to safeguard against ink leaking out of the cap in the event of any ink burping. The barrel is an entirely transparent barrel that is completely straight and has another O-ring sitting in a groove about 0.5 millimeter before the end of the barrel. The O-ring is used in posting and is responsible in keeping the cap snug on the back end when the cap is posted. Towards the last quarter of the barrel, you can see the internals of the piston mechanism. The blind cap is a hexagonal blind cap that starts with a rounded step that is the same dimensions as the barrel. The cap is also a hexagonal shaped cap. The finial is a flat finial with the brand emblem slightly raised in 3D fashion. The clip is a simple tension fixed clip with a decent amount of tension. Inside the cap is a cup that meets the end of the section that, in addition to the O-ring at the base of the section threads, aids in preventing the nib from drying out. The center band is a rounded wedding band style center band that has the brand name laser engraved on the front and Eco laser engraved on the rear. The pen was packaged in a brown branded cardboard sleeve. Slide that off and you have a rather sturdy, frosted, translucent flip open box. Open that up and you have a branded red paper cover. Open that up and you have your pen resting nicely inside of a foam cutout. Above it is a plastic wrench for disassembly and a tiny bottle of silicone grease for piston re-greasing. Also included is an instruction foldout and a little warning tab that should not be ignored as it tells you not to clean this pen with alcohol as it will dissolve the pen. That's all I have for the neutral zone. Moving on to the good. Those elements about the pen that are good. I like this pen. It writes really well. It's a smooth writer with a touch of tooth. Being that this is an extra fine, I would say that the tooth is to be expected. Having said that, for an extra fine, I would say that the tooth is more on the moderate side. When it comes to the wetness, I would say that for an extra fine nib, it is wet enough that the ink needs a few seconds to dry, but not so wet that it changes the line from an extra fine to a fine. Also, it's wet enough that saturated ink looks saturated, however, not so wet that it causes significant feathering or bleeding on cheap copy paper. When it comes to the balance, I think for those that like to write posted or unposted, either option is good. I can't really say there is much of a difference between the two. The unposted pen is long enough to write comfortably, and when posted, the cap is so light that there's almost no difference. Overall, the pen is on the lighter side, but doesn't feel cheap or feel like anything that was bought in an office supply store. I think that for a pen this light, it is pretty sturdy and a decently built pen. The cap closes nice and tight, and the blind cap feels secure when closed. There was a lot of thought given to every detail of the pen with regard to function and design. The anti-leak safeguards also result in the pen being able to remain unused for significant amounts of time without it drying out. I definitely appreciate the aesthetic. The plastic is crystal clear and looks very crisp and clean. And once again, despite the price tag, there is nothing about this pen that looks quote-unquote office supply store bought. The piston is also something that is worth mentioning. It's very smooth and very satisfying when filling. Last thing, and this could qualify as a neutral zone element for some, but I felt it belonged here in the good, is the ink capacity. This puppy holds a ton of ink. I clocked this pen to hold a whopping 2 milliliters of ink at full capacity, and that's with eliminating all the air bubbles when filling. Just to give you a gauge of how much ink that is, that's an entire internal ink sample worth of ink. It's a lot. That's all I have for the good. Moving on to the bad. Let's talk coin. This pen has an MSRP of $30.99. With retailers here in the US, you can score this pen for $30.99. Now, that's not a bad price at all, and makes this pen a fantastic choice for newer users who want to try their first piston filler. My only gripe is that it used to only cost $27.99. Now, even though that's only a few bucks and it's just a nominal amount, the difference is the difference between being able to boast that this pen was sub $30 and not. Not a deal breaker, and we'll all get past it. We'll do it together. That's all I have for the bad. Moving on to the ugly. Those elements about the pen that should not be, but are. As I said earlier, the feed is delicate. And I'm talking delicate that it makes a dandelion look like Thor's hammer. The issue with this is that if you ever want to remove the nib and feed from the section, virtually any and all pressure on the fins will cause the fins to fold down, and in some cases even break off. If that does happen, it doesn't really affect the function of the pen, but it does not look good at all. Outside of that, I haven't personally seen anything else that would qualify here in the ugly. I have heard from a friend that his pen, the nib and feed became loose to the point that it would fall out of the pen when writing just from the sheer gravity. But like I said, I have yet to personally experience that. That's all I have for the ugly. It's high noon. Decision-making time. Should you or should you not pull the trigger on the Twsbi Eco Fountain Pen? I really think that this pen is an amazing pen for the price. I think that it is a great pen for anyone, for any walk of life, with a tiny exception. And that exception is, I wouldn't personally recommend this pen to a brand new user until they are ready for their first piston filler. I recently was with a buddy, and we stopped into the fountain pen hospital for me to pick up some emergency ink. And unexpectedly, my buddy suddenly wanted to buy his first fountain pen. He asked me what to get. So, under sudden pressure to give him a perfect answer, I immediately thought of pens that are easy to use, convenient, and reliable, durable, and work every time out of the box. Now, all of those elements do apply to the Twsbi Eco, with the only thing that would be easier for a newer user would be cartridges rather than a piston filler. So in a case like that, I didn't recommend the Twsbi Eco. I recommended the Pilot Metropolitan. But for anyone else, sure, including a user that wants to get their first piston filler, all the way to the longtime experienced enthusiast, I would certainly say pull the trigger on the Twsbi Eco. That was my review of the Twsbi Eco. I hope you found it helpful. Thanks again for watching. Love you guys. Be well, be safe.
Today on the Pentatainment Podcast, we have Mr. Christopher Walken.
Hi!
Hello. Is it true that you actually use fountain pens?
Well, yeah. One day, I was in New York. I went into a shop called the Fountain Pen Hospital or something. And I saw these pens. They were expensive. And I thought to myself, what's that? It's a funny little thing. A nib. It's a funny word when you think about it. Nib. So I walk through the shop going nib, 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 and I thought, I need one of these in my life, you know? Wow, it's never been the same.